Hi guys, you are with the Tech Science, and today we discuss the formation of rainbow, which are from the chapter Refraction of Light, meant for CBSE, ICSE and State Board. Before directly start with this point, formation of rainbow or the phenomenon of rainbow, you must have know the concept of partial and total internal reflection, which just I upload yesterday only. And if you are not seeing that video, so in the description I give the link of that video. You just see that video, because to understand the phenomenon of rainbow, total internal reflection, this point you have to be clarified first of all. Okay, now let's start with the point formation of rainbow. So for the understood the formation of rainbow, we have like scenario like that. After raining, the number of like water droplets are there, which are present in the atmosphere, and here the presence of sunlight means sun is there and observer right now observing. What happened here? Here the raindrop is acts like a prism here. When the sunlight enters into the raindrop, automatically three phenomena are going on. And what are these three phenomena? First phenomena is called refraction of light occurs. Second phenomena, it is called dispersion of light occurs. The second phenomena is what? Dispersion of light occurs. And the third phenomena, it is called, actual point is reflection, but more correct is total internal reflection occur. Total internal reflection occur. Combining of these three phenomena is nothing but the point, it is called formation of rainbow. Now, as I told, the rainbow is a combined effect of all these three. Now, as we know, refraction is nothing but the phenomena of the passing of the light when it travels from one transparent medium into the another. In the refraction, there is a slight deviation of the light occurs, as we know. Second, dispersion means what? Dispersion means the white light, it gets splitted into its component color. And that nothing but a kind of spectrum occurs, nothing but the dispersion. For example, the colors which are obtained through the splitting of the white lights into the seven colors, it is called Vibjor. V-I-B-G-Y-O-R. This is what the Vibjor. What is Vibjor? It is nothing but the name of the colors: violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, and red. So this is what the splitting of the white light into its component color. It is called as the dispersion. And last, what is reflection? We know that reflection is nothing but the bounce back of the light ray after striking on any object. It is nothing but the reflection. Now, what are the conditions for total internal reflection and what is critical angle? I already told you, we have that video. That link is given in the description. You can just follow that and you can observe what is total internal reflection. Now, let's see. This is the raindrop. This is what air medium. Now, the sunlight striking, and this is what the denser medium. Am I right? This is what the denser medium. Now, when the light ray strike on this water droplet, or it's called raindrop, at this point, two phenomena are occur. The first phenomenon is what? The refraction of light also occur. And second, dispersion also occurs. So here, this point we consider as A. And here, the white light, the incident light ray, gets splitted into its seven component color. This color indicated by red line, suppose this is the red color, and this is what? Violet color, okay? So, these five colors are considered, imagine they are in between these two, okay? So, it is not possible to write all the seven colors, that diagram become complex, that's why I use only the first and the least color. So, this is one red, and this is one violet. Here, the refractive index of the water, here for the red color it is very least, and for the violet it is maximum. For the reason, violet it is like light rays deviates more compared to the red. Now, at one edge of the raindrops, at point A, here refraction plus dispersion both occurs, and when it reach at the other end of the other edge of the raindrop, now at this point these all seven colors, they are reflected back, and here total internal reflection occur. Now question is what are the two mandatory condition for the total internal reflection? Why it not get refracted here? Why the all red light rays are not, seven colors are not refracted from this side? Because at this point the angle of incidence is greater than critical angle. The angle of incidence is greater than the critical angle, and that's why total internal reflection occurs. And this edge completely reflect the light, and they come to this point. And after reaching this point, there is again a refraction occurs, and they are leave this rarer denser medium and comes into the air medium again. This is what the phenomena of the rainbow, formation of the rainbow, where refraction of the light occurs two times at this point and this point also. Dispersion occurs one time here and total internal reflection occurs one time here, and the formation of rainbow occurs. Now question is what is the condition for the formation of rainbow? So here three objects are there. Presence of sunlight means sun, second presence of the water droplets in the atmosphere, and third observer. So the setting is like that, when the observer's back is towards the sun, then in front of the observer rainbow occurs. This is the mandatory condition. So in between the sun and the rainbow there should be an observer, but the observer's back is towards the sun. So this is the formation of a rainbow. Okay, I hope you understood this concept, and if you like this video, please subscribe the channel and press the bell icon for the new notification. Thank you.